These are tips. The one I learned them, I thought, how did I not know this already existed? If you've been using After Effects for a while, you'll probably already know a few, but I'm sure there'll be some gems in there that will save you a lot of time and trouble in your projects. Let's get started. You've got some layers, one has some cool effects on it that you'd like to apply to the others. We can copy those effects up here in the Effects Control panel and paste them onto another layer, but you can also select those effects, go to Edit and select Copy with Property Links, paste them onto another layer, and if you change those effects in the original layer, they will change on every layer they were copied to, wherever they are in the project. Alright, we've got this texture set to multiply and we want to apply it to this pentagon, but we don't want to deal with any mats or masks. We can simply select Preserve Underlaying Transparency down here, and it will only apply to already visible layers in your composition. You can apply the blending mode Stencil Alpha to make visible only layers that appear underneath that layer. You can also use the blending mode Silhouette Alpha to get the reverse, which makes everything underneath that layer transparent. Say you've got a logo or a vector element, but when you scale it up, it goes all blurry or pixelated. If you tick Continuously Rasterize down here, it turns nice and crisp. We've got two layers doing some animation with their position. To move them to the left without pre-comping might be tricky, but we can create a new null object, parent those two layers to that null, move the null over to the left where we want them, then delete the null, removing all evidence that we were ever here. If you've got a timeline full of layers and you need to see more of it, if you've got your cursor over it and press the tilde key, which is the curly one next to the one on the top left of your keyboard, press it over that panel and it will make it full screen. And you press tilde again, it will minimize it back to your previous view. It works on any panel. If you want to navigate through your project quickly, use the mini flowchart. If we go into this text comp and press tab on our keyboard, it'll bring up this flowchart wherever your cursor is. It shows the comp that we're in, and on the left it shows all the comps that this is nested in, and on the right it shows all the comps that are inside this comp, the stars and the balls. The blue line indicates which comp you came from, in our case it was comp 7. If you want to change something in your pre-comp and see what it looks like in the above comps, you can split your view by locking a comp in your view here, opening another comp, and dragging that out. Now you can go inside and make any edits in this comp on the right, and they will update in the main comp on the left here. And you can easily see how it will affect the comps above it. If you want to align some objects together, you can do that with guides. Just simply drag out some guides, select view, snap to guides, and whenever you move an object, it will snap into position. If the duration in your comp is too long, you can drag over your work area in your timeline view, and then simply right-click Trim Comp to Work Area. If you want to reduce the size of your comp, perhaps to fit a layer, click on the region of interest down here and drag out the area that you would like it to crop to, and then select Composition, Crop Comp to Region of Interest. If you want to parent one layer to another, but you don't want it to inherit all of the properties, you can Alt or Option click on the property you want to parent and then pick whip that to the specific property on the other layer. Now our pentagon is inheriting our square's rotation, but not its position. We want to create a mask on this pentagon, but our pen tool just keeps drawing shapes. If we select Tool Creates Mask and draw over the top, now it creates a mask. The different blur effects in After Effects work slightly differently. Box blur and camera lens blur get a more natural blurring, but it does take longer to render, and Gaussian blur tends to be the fastest, so choose wisely. If you blur an image, it will automatically assume the edges of the image are transparent, so you'll get this halo effect on the edges where you see the layer underneath. Tick Repeat Edge Pixels to stop that happening. But don't feel too bad, the Walking Dead titles didn't realize this until season 3. To cycle through the fill or stroke modes, hold Alt and click on the square next to the mode and it will cycle through all of your options. You can also hold Alt and click through to cycle all the different tool modes. If you want to duplicate a layer, press Ctrl D to get another version. And if you want to split that layer, press Ctrl Shift D and it will split it at your playhead. To move the start of your layer to your playhead, press the left square bracket on your keyboard, and press the right square bracket on your keyboard to move the end to your playhead. To trim your layer, press Alt and hold the left square bracket to trim it at the beginning, and Alt and the right square bracket to trim it at the end. If you've animated some transform properties like scale, position, rotation on your layer and you'd like to add more while keeping the existing animation without adding a null or pre-comping, you can add the effect transform. And this will give you more options to keyframe. If suddenly your bounding box disappears and you don't have the outlines of your shape layers visible, you might have accidentally turned them off. I do this all the time. To turn them back on, click this bounding box button here, or go up to View, Show Layer Controls. If your project panel suddenly disappears, to get it back, press Ctrl and 0. I do this all the time as well because that is the Fit to View shortcut in Photoshop, and I do it without thinking. If you want to line up elements from one comp to another, or quickly reference another comp, you can take a snapshot of it. by clicking this camera icon here. And then from whatever other COM you're in, you can click the View Snapshot button, and it will make that snapshot visible for you to use as reference. We've got the square moving with its position property. To get the rotation to follow along, we can select Layer, Transform, Auto Orient, and select Orient Along Path. And now the rotation follows along. To create a quick sine wave, select your line, go to Add, select Zig Zag, toggle that down, adjust the size and the amount of ridges, and then change the points from corner to smooth. If you're tired of flat vector shapes, use the Rough and Edges effect and tweak some of the settings to add a bit of grit to your animation. If you want to slightly expand or reduce the edges of your layer, simply add the effect Simple Choker and adjust the choke mat. This is also great for adding rounded corners. If you want to quickly offset or stagger your layers, select them all, trim their length to the amount you want to offset, right click, select Keyframe Assistant, Sequence Layers, click OK, and then drag out the ends of all of them. To convert text to a shape layer, with your text tool selected, right click and select Create Shapes from Text. Now you've got your text editable as paths. If you want to morph a square into a circle, keyframe its roundness at 0, move ahead and drag it up to its maximum roundness, where it will be a circle. And there you are. You can do basic math operations in any number field. If the number is inconvenient to calculate yourself, let After Effects do it. This square is 400 pixels wide, and I want it to move that far to the right. So in its position property, I'm going to select its current position and add plus 400 and press enter. And there we go. You can use multiply and divide in here too. If you need some free space on your hard drive, your disk cache might be using up more than it needs to. You can clear your disk cache by going to Edit, Purge, All Memory and Disk Cache, and click OK to clear out some memory from projects you might not have opened in years. If your project is getting bloated with a bunch of assets and comps that you no longer need, you can go to File, and then down to Dependencies, and remove unused footage. You can also reduce the project to only the files needed in the comps you have selected, and then you can also collect all of your files and every linked asset into a folder, which is very useful if you need to hand the project onto someone else on another machine or using another server. If you want to know what comp an asset was used in, you can right click over in the project panel and select Reveal in Composition, which will take you to it. You can also do it in reverse too. You can right click, select Reveal, Reveal Layer Source in Project, and you can also right click and select Reveal, Reveal in Explorer, to find the exact source of that file. If you need to replace a file or composition, you can select it down in your timeline, find the layer or comp you'd like to replace it with in the project panel, hold Alt, and simply drag it into your composition or timeline window. And it will replace it, keeping all the original animated properties. Select your comp in the project window and drag it onto the new composition window, and that will create a new comp with the exact same size duration of that original comp, with that comp nested inside. If you want an image or comp to be the exact height or width of a comp without doing it by hand and eyeballing it with a scale property, select Layer, Transform, Fit to Comp Height, or Width, depending on your needs. Use the search bar down in your timeline to easily access properties like Path or Stroke Width, without toggling down a whole bunch of layers. We've got this pre-comped animation of a snowman shape bouncing, and we want to add a quick shadow to it. We can duplicate it with Command D, add a fill effect, select our shadow color, then add the CC slant effect, adjust the slant and the height, send that layer behind, and now we've got an animated shadow. If you've got an animation in a pre-comp, you can change the speed by right-clicking and select Time, Time Stretch. 50% makes it twice as fast, 200 makes it twice as slow. To reverse it, right-click and select Time, Time Reverse Layer. If you have nothing selected in your timeline, to add markers to the comp, press asterisk on your keyboard and it will create a marker here. If you do it with the layer selected, it will create one on the layer. You can double click to add a comment to that marker, or if you hold Alt and click the asterisk, it will open up that dialog box as you create the marker. You can also hold Alt on your keyboard and drag a marker to extend it to encompass a duration rather than a single point. If you want to reverse some properties of an animation, you can select the keyframes you want reversed, right click, select Keyframe Assistant and Time Reverse Keyframes, and that will swap the values of those keyframes. If you want to extend an animation but keep the same timing, you can select all the keyframes and then while holding Alt, select the first or last keyframe and drag it out to keep those proportions exactly the same. You can also press J and K on your keyboard to jump your playhead to the nearest keyframe. J goes to the nearest previous keyframe, and K to the nearest upcoming keyframe. If you've got a whole bunch of layers taking up your timeline and you don't need to see them all for now, select all of the ones you want to hide, click the shy icon, lock the layer over here, and click the shy icon over here. Now they're hidden and there's no chance you're accidentally going to move them. And now you've got a lovely clean timeline. And if you just need to view one or a couple of layers in your composition window, you can click the solo button here on as many of the layers as you need, so you're not distracted by the other layers, and so After Effects doesn't need to render those layers as well. Very useful if you're using a lot of effects or a render heavy comp. If you want to apply an effect to the whole scene and not just one element, instead of pre-comping, you can use an adjustment layer. Create a new adjustment layer by going up to Layer, New, Adjustment Layer, and whatever effects you apply to that layer will affect everything beneath it. Change the color of your layers in your timeline to keep it organized. Click the colored square down here and choose any color you want. If you choose Select Label Group, it'll select all layers with that color. Very handy when you're working with a lot of layers. If you've pasted something and After Effects has pasted them in the wrong order, here our bottom text should be underneath this rectangle. To get it to paste in the right order, you need to select your top layer first, then the others, copy or cut, and then paste them. And the layer you selected first will arrive on top in the layer stack. If you want to quickly test a bunch of fonts, select your text, click in the font drop-down area, and scroll through with your arrow keys till you find the font you like. You can also click this star over here on the left, and that will put them in this favorite folder, so you can access the fonts you always use. If you're annoyed that when you create a new shape layer, the anchor point goes to the middle of the comp rather than the middle of the shape layer, you can fix that by going to Edit, Preferences, General, and select Center Anchor Point in New Shape Layers. Ah, isn't that nicer?
I've made a short playlist of some related videos that I think you'll enjoy if you've made it this far. I'll see you in the next video, and please consider subscribing if you'd like more of these videos every week.